and you have already understood the concept of types of adsorption. So in that very lecture you have understood there are two types of adsorption. One is called as physical adsorption and second is called as chemical adsorption. This was all about the types of adsorption. Now today's lecture is the factors on which adsorption depends. There are large number of factors on which adsorption depends, but in today's lecture I will discuss three important factors on which the adsorption depends, which is in your syllabi. The first factor is that can be called as effect of volume. Number first is the effect of volume on adsorption. Number second is effect of temperature. Yeah, I can say here effect of pressure. And last one that you have read, that is the effect of temperature. There are three important factors on which adsorption depends. First is the effect of volume. Second is the effect of pressure. Third is the effect of temperature. Among these three factors, there are two very important factors as far as your NEET level is concerned. One is the effect of pressure and the second important is the effect of temperature. First of all, let me have a brief account about the effect of volume on the adsorption. Now, first of all, I can say here effect of volume. What is the role of volume on the adsorption? It is quite a bit very simple. Simple in the sense, with the increase in volume, you can say here, with the increase in volume, there is increase in surface area. Yeah, I can say with the increase in the surface area, there is increase in the volume. Yeah, I can say in reverse direction. With the increase in the volume, there is increase in the surface area of adsorbent. You have read the adsorbent. Adsorbent is the surface on which adsorption takes place. So remember the point, with the increase in the volume, there is increase in the surface area of the adsorbent. With the increase in the surface area of the adsorbent, there is increase in adsorption. Remember the point, with the increase in the surface area of the adsorbent, means with the increase in the volume, there is increase in the adsorption. Now, we can say if you have got adsorbent in powdered form, this powdered form adsorbent has got higher surface area than that of the adsorbent present in the form of clamps. This powdered form adsorbent has got higher surface area, thus it has got higher adsorption than that of that adsorbate which is present in the form of clamps. Remember the parity. With the increase in the surface area, there is increase in the adsorption, because adsorption directly depends on the surface area of the adsorbent. That's why when adsorbent is present in the powdered form, it has got higher adsorption than that of that adsorbent which is present in the form of clamps. This was a brief account about the effect of volume. We can also say if the gas, yeah, if the adsorbate is polar. Next point I'll add here. If the adsorbate is polar, it has got stronger affinity to form the intermolecular force with that of the adsorbent. Therefore, there will be increase in the extent of adsorption. Remember, when adsorbate is polar, it forms stronger intermolecular force with the adsorbent. Due to the formation of stronger intermolecular force with the adsorbent, there is increase in the extent of adsorption. And likewise, I'll quote example here, if you take the ammonia gas is polar in nature, it forms the stronger intermolecular force with that of the adsorbent. due to the formation of stronger intermolecular force with that of the adsorbent, there is increase in the extent of adsorption. Likewise, if you take a non-polar adsorbate, non-polar adsorbate forms weaker intermolecular force with that of adsorbent. Due to the formation of weak intermolecular force with that of the adsorbent, there is decrease in the extent of adsorption. Likewise, if you take here nitrogen gas, if you take here oxygen gas, these gases have got a lower extent of adsorption than that of the ammonia gas. This is because of the presence of non-polar nature. This was a brief account about the effect of volume on the extent of adsorption. Now, second concept which is very much important for you people, that is the effect of pressure. Very important concept. That is the effect of pressure. Try to understand this very important concept. It is very important. There are two important concepts, as I told you earlier. One is the effect of pressure, second is the effect of temperature. Now, important point number first, in order to study the effect of pressure on adsorption, the point first is you have to keep the temperature constant. Number first point, it must be clear to you, in order to study the effect of pressure on the adsorption, you have to keep the temperature constant. Now, if you take the temperature constant, that concept is called as isotherm. Yeah, that process can be called as isothermal process. As you have read in your previous class, that process which takes place at constant temperature is called as isothermal process. In this case, you have to study the effect of pressure, but you have to keep the temperature constant. Therefore, that can be called as isotherm. That can be called as isothermal process. Now, my concept is very much simple. I have to study the effect of pressure on adsorption. The study of effect of pressure on the adsorption, keeping the temperature constant. Remember, I'll repeat. The study of effect of pressure on the adsorption, keeping the temperature constant, is called as adsorption isotherm. It's called as adsorption isotherm. Now, what's adsorption isotherm? It is the study of effect of pressure on the adsorption, keeping the temperature constant. That's called as adsorption isotherm. The concept of adsorption isotherm was initially given by Friedlich. So that is why it is called as Friedlich adsorption isotherm. Remember, so first of all, you have to understand what is adsorption isotherm. It is the study of effect of pressure on the adsorption, keeping the temperature constant. That's called as adsorption isotherm. It was first of all studied by Friedlich, so called as Friedlich adsorption isotherm. You can later on, it was modified by Langmuir. It was also modified by Langmuir. So it can be also called as Langmuir adsorption isotherm. Actually, Friedlich adsorption isotherm was modified by Langmuir. So therefore, it's called as Langmuir adsorption isotherm. Later on, it was modified by more three sites, so called as Beckettherm, BET, which you study in your higher level. So, adsorption isotherm, you have understood, it is the effect of, the study of effect of pressure on the adsorption, keeping the temperature constant. That's called absorption isotherm. It was initially given by Freundlich, so called Freundlich absorption isotherm. Later on, it was modified by Langmuir, so called Langmuir absorption isotherm. Got it? Now, I'll take this topic ahead. In this very important topic, Freundlich or Langmuir has used the term, that term is called as extent of absorption. A term was used, that term is called as extent of adsorption. What is mean by extent of adsorption? I can say here, extent of absorption is the ratio of mass of adsorbate. It is the ratio of mass of adsorbate that I take in terms of the x. The extent of adsorption means the ratio of mass of adsorbate to the mass of adsorbent. I'll repeat, in this isotherm, a term was used, that term is called as extent of adsorption. It is defined as the ratio of mass of the adsorbate to the mass of adsorbent. Mass of adsorbate is represented by here x. X here denotes the mass of the adsorbate. Mass of the adsorbent, I denote it by means of m, small case m. Small case m will denote the mass of the adsorbent. So I write here extent of adsorption. Extent of adsorption is mathematically equal to x by m. Remember again, extent of adsorption is defined as the ratio of mass of the adsorbate to the mass of the adsorbent. This mass of the adsorbate is represented by x, and the mass of adsorbent is represented by m. So x by m will represent the mass, will represent the extent of adsorption. Now I'll take your topic into account. We have to study the effect of pressure on the adsorption, keeping the temperature constant. Now there are three important cases which you have to understand. Case number first, very important case, three important cases, but I'll take case number first. Case number first is, it has been seen that at low pressure, I can say here at low pressure, what happens? It has been seen that extent of adsorption directly depends on pressure. That means if you increase the pressure, there is formation of stronger intermolecular force between the adsorbate and the adsorbent. That's why there is increase in the extent of adsorption. That I write mathematically, x by m, you know it is the extent of adsorption that directly depends on p. P means here pressure. More you apply the pressure, more will be the extent of adsorption. Now this is right here, in other words, x by m, you know it is the extent of adsorption, it is equal to k, a constant, then p, x by m is equal to kp, while k is a constant, k is equal to constant. This was information number first. Now I'll repeat, at low pressure, it has been seen that extent of adsorption directly depends on the pressure applied. More you apply the pressure, more will be the extent of adsorption. In actual sense, you can say when you apply the pressure, there is decrease in volume. Due to decrease in volume, the adsorbate comes close to that of the adsorbent, forming the stronger intermolecular forces. Due to the formation of stronger intermolecular forces, there will be increase in the extent of adsorption. This was case first. And in the case first, we have studied, in the case first that extent of absorption directly depends on the pressure applied. As you all know, here is the power of 1. Now let me take the case second into account. Now first of all, if you take a graphical representation, let me show you the graph first, then I will go for the case second. So in this axis you are taking x by n. What is x by n? It is the extent of adsorption. Remember, here in this axis you are taking the pressure. So what is the initial concept? You say that slope of the graph will come out to be linear. Slope of the graph will state you that with the increase in the pressure, there is also increase in the extent of adsorption. So the value of the slope will be x by m is equal to kp raised power 1. The slope of this graph comes out to be linear. Now let me take the second case into account. I'll take the case second into account. Case second. Now I'll take second case. I have told you earlier there are three important concepts which you have to learn in this topic. Case first, you have understood extent of adsorption directly depends on the pressure applied. Now I can say here at high pressure. Now I may take at high pressure. What is the concept at high pressure? It has been seen that at high pressure, extent of adsorption is independent on pressure. I write here P raised power 0. Why P raised power 0? It means the extent of adsorption does not depend on or is independent on the pressure applied. Why? Why? It's independent. Because the active sites present in the adsorbent has already occupied by the adsorbee. There are no more active sites. What do you mean by here active sites? It means the residual valencies are occupied by the adsorbent. There are no further residual valency to that of the adsorbent. Now, what will be the graphical presentation? So, graphical presentation will be like this. The slope will be parallel to that of the pressure axis. The pressure at which adsorption is independent on the pressure at which extent of adsorption is independent on the pressure, that pressure is called as saturation pressure. That I represent in terms of PS. The pressure at which extent of adsorption is independent on the pressure is called as saturation pressure. What do you mean by saturation pressure? It is the pressure at which adsorption is independent on the pressure. That pressure can be called as saturation pressure. So from this to this, what will be the value of the slope? The value of the slope will be x by m. What is it? It is the extent of adsorption. It is proportional to P raised to the power 0. What does P raised power 0 here means? It is independent on the pressure applied. Why? You know, because the residual valencies are already occupied by the adsorbent. There will be no further adsorption. That I write mathematically at high pressure x by m, that's extent of adsorption is independent on pressure. So I write here x by m is equal to kp raised to the power 0. What is here k? Again, k is a constant. So from this to this, what we have learned? We have learned that extent of adsorption directly depends on the pressure applied. From this point to this point, what we have learned? We have learned that extent of adsorption is independent on pressure. So I repeat a concept. At low pressure, I write here at low pressure, graph states that extent of adsorption is directly proportional to the pressure applied. But at high pressure, extent of adsorption is independent on the pressure. This was the case second. So let me take now at intermediate pressure. We have stated the two cases. One was at low pressure, second was at high pressure. What at case third? I will take case third. In the case third, I will take at intermediate pressure. What at intermediate pressure? Remember the students, at high pressure the equation is x by m is proportional to p raised to the power 0 at high pressure. This is at high pressure. X already clear from the graph. But at low pressure, you have read x by m is proportional to p raised power 1. So this is at high pressure, which you know x by m is proportional to p. This is at low pressure. Now, what is at intermediate pressure? If you get it, that means the value will lie in between 1 and 0. At intermediate pressure, the intermediate pressure is the pressure which lies in between 1, which is at low, possible at low pressure, and 0, which is possible at high pressure. So what about the intermediate pressure now? How are at intermediate pressure? Intermediate pressure lies between 0 and 1. Between 0 and 1, I will represent these values as 1 by n. Those values, the intermediate values of pressure, I will represent in terms of 1 by n. In the mathematical sense, they are equal to 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, ultimately 0.9, and at last it is the 1. So these values I will represent in terms of 1 by n. But remember, it was asked in NEET also, 1 by n is greater than that of the 0. And this 1 is greater than that of 1 by n. You can say 1 by n is less than that of the 1. So now you have got the value of pressure in terms of 1 by n. If you talk about the intermediate pressure, mathematically this can be stated as x by m is proportional to p raised power 1 by n. 0 is possible at high pressure and 1 is possible at low pressure. 1 by n is possible at the intermediate pressure. So now we can write x by m at intermediate pressure. You can write x by m. What is it? Is the extent of the pressure? It directly depends on p raised power 1 by n. What this 1 by n is? It is a value which lies in between the low pressure and the high pressure, which I have represented in terms of p raised power 1 by n. So I can modify equation. I write x by m is equal to kp raised to the power 1 by n. Now, x by m is what it is? Is the extent of the absorption. What is here k? It's a constant. What is here p? It is a pressure. What is here again 1 by n? It is a value which lies in between 0 and 1. Now let me take the value of 1 by n now. In order to calculate the value of 1 by n, I'll take log on both sides. Is graph clear to you? Now, I'll take log on both sides. What this equation will become? It's log of x by n. It's a log of x by n that is equal to log of k p raised to the power 1 by n. Is it clear? Now proceed this equation ahead. I'll say these are the two terms. This is k is one term and p raised power 1 by n is other term. It's actually log of m into n. I write it like this. I write here log of x by m is equal to log of k plus log of p raised to the power 1 by n. Is it clear? It's actually log of m into log of m is equal to log of m plus log of n. Now proceed ahead. I take this equation, the logical conclusion. I write here log of x by m is equal to here log of k plus its log of m raised to the power n is equal to 1 by n log of p. Anybody having any problem? Now I'll compare this equation with straight line in slow form. I write here, comparing the equation, with I write here y is equal to mx plus c, which you know from the mathematics point of view, this equation is called straight line in slow form. That means on the basis of slope, we can calculate the value of 1 by n. Now, as far as this equation is concerned, y is here log of x by n. Remember, y is here log of x by n. And m here denotes the slope. The slope is this one, 1 by n log of p, this mx. Mx is here 1 by n log of p, this one. This term 1 by n log of p represents the mx. And c, as you know, c is the intercept. This intercept is here log of k. So I will write it in this form. I write here y is here same. I write here it's equal to the log of x by m. It's here same. That is equal to mx. What is mx? This is the mx. So mx is actually 1 by n log of p. Clear? Then plus c. C is the intercept. What is the value of intercept? That is equal to log of k. So this is here y. This is here y. It is here mx. And this is here c. What is here c? C is the intercept. If you are aware about this equation, this the value of the slope is positive. The value of the slope is positive. That means slope will be the upwards. If it had been negative, then the slope would have been downwards. Let me plot a graph first. I will plot a graph. So the graph, I'll write here, this is the y-axis. This is the y here. What is the value of y here? It's log of x by n. It's log of x by n. What here represents, you know, it is the pressure. Now, what is the slope? Shall I show slope upwards or downwards? I have to show slope upwards. What is the value of the slope? It is 1 by n log of p. Is there intercept? Yeah, there is intercept. That's equal to k. As you know, intercept is the distance from the initial of this graph to the initial of this slope. The value of this intercept is that is equal to log of k. This is the equation. This slope is mathematically calculated by using tan of theta. This was the information about the effect of pressure on the extent of adsorption. Got it? Any confusion? Now, I will take the next concept into account, the last one, which is the effect of temperature. I may take here the effect of temperature. It's quite a bit, again, simple as far as chemistry is concerned. Let me take the effect of temperature. Number third factor, that is the effect of temperature. Two important factors you have understood. One was the volume. Second was the effect of pressure. And third is the effect of temperature. Now, point number first. In order to study the effect of temperature on extent of adsorption, remember what I write. In order to study the effect of temperature on the extent of adsorption, you have to keep the pressure constant. Remember it. I'll repeat, in order to study the effect of temperature on the extent of adsorption, you have to keep the pressure constant. Now, you know those processes which takes place at constant pressure, it's called as isobar. What's isobar? Those processes which takes place at constant pressure. Now, what is mean by what is mean by adsorption isobar? In the previous concept, you have understood adsorption isothermal. What is adsorption isobar? It is the study of effect of temperature on the extent of adsorption, keeping the temperature keeping the pressure constant. Adsorption isobar is the study of effect of temperature on the extent of adsorption, keeping the pressure constant. What is that called as? That's called as adsorption isobar. Got it? I'll repeat. The study of effect of temperature on the extent of adsorption, keeping the pressure constant, is called as adsorption isobar. Now, as far as the adsorption isobar is concerned, there arises two concepts. Two concepts there arise. One is the effect of temperature on physical adsorption. Physical adsorption. And second is the effect of temperature on the chemical adsorption. First is effect of temperature on physical. Now, first of all, you must know that adsorption is exothermic process. If you read, the enthalpy of adsorption, that is equal to negative. Whenever adsorption takes place, energy is released. You must know this point. Adsorption is exothermic. And you have read, those processes which are exothermic are feasible or spontaneous only at low temperature. This means that physical adsorption is feasible, spontaneous, only at low temperature. This is because at high temperature, there is breakdown of the physical forces between the adsorbate and the adsorbent. That's why physical adsorption is feasible only at low temperature. If you are interested to form the adsorption isobar, in this side you are taking extent of adsorption, that's x by m. In this side you are taking the temperature. The slope of this graph will be like this, parabola type. What this will give information? It will give information that with the increase in the temperature, there is decrease in the extent of adsorption. This is because of the breakdown of the physical forces between the adsorbate and the adsorbent. This was about the physical adsorption. Now, let me take the case of chemical adsorption. As far as chemical adsorption is concerned, let me take the case of chemical adsorption. What is the role of temperature in case of chemical adsorption? You have read that in the chemical adsorption, there is formation of a chemical bond between the adsorbate and the adsorbent. That means chemical adsorption is a chemical process. For that chemical process, you may know there is need of the energy that's called as activation energy. You know that energy is provided by means of the temperature. That's why initially, with the increase in temperature, there is increase in extent of adsorption. Because this temperature provides necessary activation energy for this chemical process. And later on, when it gains the required activation energy further, if you increase the temperature, there is decrease in extent of adsorption. That means there takes place desorption. So if I pull out a graph, the graph will be like this. So in this axis, you are taking extent of adsorption. And in this axis, you are taking the temperature. The slope of this graph will be like this. That means from this point to this point, you will see that extent of adsorption increases with the increase in temperature. because temperature provides necessary activation energy for this process. And further, if the reaction has gained the sustainable equation energy, further, if you increase the temperature, there will take place desorption. That means further increase in temperature will break the chemical bond between the adsorbent and the adsorbent. That's why this process, as you know, it's called as desorption. So remember again, in case of physical adsorption, with the increase in temperature, there is decrease in extent of adsorption. In case of chemical adsorption, first of all, if you increase the temperature, there is increase in extent of adsorption, because temperature provides necessary activation energy for this process. This was all about the factors on which the adsorption depends. And this was the important points about the first was the effect of volume. You have read an effect of volume. With the increase in the volume, there is increase in the surface area. Due to increase in the surface area of adsorbent, there is increase in the extent of adsorption. Number second, you have understood the concept of effect of pressure. In that many case, the important concept was that was called as adsorption isotherm. In that many concept you have understood, first of all, if you increase the pressure, there is increase in extent of adsorption. And at high pressure, you have read, extent of adsorption is independent on the pressure, because all the residual valencies are already being satisfied. Now, in the last context, you have read the effect of temperature. In that very case, you have read, when you increase the temperature, there is a decrease in extent of Fizeau adsorption. And in case of chemi, when you increase the temperature, there is first of all increase in extent of adsorption, because temperature provides necessary activation energy for the process. This is enough for today, and wish you all the best.